Okay, so in the process of playing with the Anthropic Claude models, both on the UI and also the API, I came across a number of interesting resources that they've got on their website for basically helping you how to prompt this. And this is something that I've been looking at recently for a number of different models. So it's not just Anthropic specific, but one of the challenges that a lot of the models have is that everybody is so used to the OpenAI way of prompting that each of the models kind of needs to be prompted in slightly a different way. So this is one of the things that people would say, that you couldn't get the Gemini models to do certain things that the OpenAI models could do. And the thing that I found is you could, but you needed to rewrite the prompt in some way. And that might be that you need to change the context, perhaps you need to change the phrasing, etc., of how you're actually getting the model to do this. Now, of course, the same thing is true for the Anthropic models, right? That they have a different feel about them than the OpenAI models. So I thought it was very interesting that Anthropic themselves has basically released a bunch of guides and tools and stuff like that around prompting their models. So this is the first one that I found. This is basically just like a prompt library where you can come in here, you can look up different things. The other day we were looking at sort of doing some things with websites. So you can see how you would write the system prompt, how you would basically customize a user prompt, et cetera, for this kind of thing. And I think that there are lots of things out there kind of like this. The other ones that I found really interesting was their whole cookbook on GitHub. So on GitHub, they've got a whole cookbook of doing different things with function calling, doing different things with multimodal and stuff like that. And OpenAI has a really nice cookbook as well that you can go and look at and see how they've done things there. The third one, and the one that I wanted to really focus on in this video, is this whole idea of a Metaprompt. Now, this is something I know that a number of the other language model companies have looked at, because I've heard people talk about it when giving feedback and stuff like that. And this is the whole idea of having some kind of system that can interpret a prompt from one LLM to another LLM, or to basically have a meta prompt that works out, okay, if you want that, you need to write the prompt in a certain way. So this is what Anthropic has released here. They've basically put it in a Google Colab notebook and allows you to sort of go through and fill out the notebook as long as you've got an API key, and then it will write the sort of core prompt for you of what you should be doing. So I think this is a really useful tool for when you want to make a product or when you want a very specific kind of response or style coming back from the large language model. So let's jump into the Google Colab and have a look at actually how this works and give it a little test run. All right, so this is the Metaprompt Colab here that's from Anthropic. I've modified it a little bit just to basically put in the Anthropic API key. So using secrets in Colab, you should definitely be doing that. It just makes your notebooks a lot safer and also makes it a lot easier to basically use these kind of things. So first you come through and it will install the Anthropic package for you. And then basically you set it up with your key. Now you can pick the model. I'm going for the Opus model, but you could actually go for the Sonnet model, I guess, if you wanted to do that. And so basically they've got the sort of idea here is that they've got this meta prompt. Now the meta prompt in itself, one is very long, but two is quite instructional too about prompt engineering and prompt engineering on the Anthropic Claude 3 models, I would say. So you can see that basically it sort of starts out with, today you'll be writing instructions to an eager, helpful, but inexperienced and unworldly AI assistant who needs careful instruction and examples to understand best how to behave. I will explain the task to you. You will then write the instructions that will direct the assistant on how best to accomplish the task consistently, accurately, and correctly. Here are some examples. So the first thing it's doing is basically setting the sort of frame. It's interesting that they're going to be using exemplars in here. And exemplars in the Claude models, they tend to sort of do it with a kind of HTML or XML sort of format of where basically you've got task instruction, you're wrapping the task, you've got inputs. Now, these are things that can be injected in later on. And you'll see that it basically goes through a set of exemplars of how to sort of do this. for a variety of different tasks. So it's just sort of priming the model to be able to do a variety of different tasks. Now, one of the things that I see people make the biggest mistake normally is that their prompts, when they're trying to do something reasonably complicated, their prompts are just way too short for agents, for things like this. And I think this really kind of enforces that. If you go through and sort of look at how many different examples that they've got in here, now, maybe you could argue that some of them are not needed and stuff like that. But I do find it's like very interesting to sort of see that this is what they're sort of saying is best practice for their model for this. It's also got some examples of doing function calling in here as well, using the scratch pad, passing things back from the scratch pad, etc., going through this. And then it finally ends off with these instructions. So it talks about to write your instructions, follow these instructions. And then it gives it information about the input tags, the input structure, and those kind of things. And then at the end, it has a bunch of these notes, which I think are kind of interesting in themselves. So things like, this is probably obvious to you already, but you are not completing the task here. You are writing the instructions for an AI to complete the task. Another name for what you're writing is a prompt template. So it's kind of giving the model lots of things to sort of attach to this. Now, then you come basically down here and you select out what it is that the task that you want it to do. Now, I've put in a really simple example of draft an email responding to a customer inquiring about attending a course. Okay, the original example that they had in here was draft an email responding to a customer complaint in there. Now, here's where it gets interesting. So at this point, you can pass in sort of what the variables should be. So for example, if you're doing the customer complaint thing, you could pass in the variables being one, a customer complaint, and two, the company name. So you wouldn't actually pass in the customer complaint yet. You're just telling it that, hey, reserve a variable for this. Then we're going to use that with the actual prompt that it generates for doing the task. And you see another one, choose an item from a menu for me, given my preferences. Then you've got the menu, and then you've got preferences would be the inputs that go with these. Now, if you leave it blank, like I do, you're actually leaving it so that the model itself can decide what it thinks should be the input. So I think that's kind of interesting in itself. If I was really doing something for putting something in production, I would certainly do one or a couple of runs where I just get it to decide the variables and see what does it kind of think that it needs to be able to do this task. All right, once we've done that, we've got the task, we've set these variables to be either empty or we put some in, we can actually just go through and sort of run the first sort of prompt making part. So this is now where what it's going to do is it's going to basically work out the meta prompt. What it's going to do is it's going to basically use the meta prompt to create back the prompt that you want. So remember, my one was respond to an email about courses in here. And so you can see here that it's basically done this. It's decided, I guess, that you need the customer email, which the customer has sent in, and then the course details for this. Now, I could have probably made the task a lot more detailed and provided that this is in response to a form on a website. The details that we have about them are their name, about the company, their email, that kind of thing that's in there. And then it basically does this instruction structure. Here it's going through and it's writing out the specific things. Now you can see that this is broken down into a lot more detail than we would normally get if we were probably just writing this into a box ourselves. And I think this is where the Metaprompt really can shine, is that when you've got these kind of things, it can really assist in getting just a much better prompt for this. This idea is not new. OpenAI's DALL-E has used this for a long time, both for good things and bad things, right? So if you look at their sort of DALL-E system prompt, they have things in there filtering out any artists that might have copyrighted work. They want to give diverse responses. Obviously, Google recently got into a lot of hot water with their prompt rewriting that they were doing. So when people were writing something in, there was then like another meta prompt that was writing it for the images. We tend to see it more for, I guess we've tended to see it more for image creation than just sort of text response, stuff like that. But this is definitely something that's useful and you could build yourself if you had customers inputting something and You want to rewrite their prompt. If someone says, show me my balance or something like that, and you know that you've got certain information about what their account is and this like that, you could rewrite the prompt, which will then go to some other system. Now, I've done some examples of this, of rewriting queries for RAG. It's a very common thing where you basically do a rewrite of the query to do a better search, that kind of thing. Okay, so we can see that we've got this sort of instruction structure. We've got the instructions being much more specific. And then we can see the inputs that it wants here is the customer email, which it's wrapping in XML, and the course details, again, wrapping it in XML. It goes through, gives us some more details in here. And then at the end, it's got this remember, be polite, positive, professional tone. And this is where you could actually sort of inject certain things about your company. The idea is that once you're not going to perhaps run this every time, you're going to then take this prompt and then reuse it many times, or give it to people on your team, or give it to people on your staff, that kind of thing here. All right, so we've got that. And then finally, if we want to actually run it on what we've got in here, we can actually go through and we can run it where we pass this in and it will then prompt us. It will then basically prompt us for the different things. It prompted us here for the customer email. I typed in this. It then prompted for the course details. I put some course details in there, etc. And then it went on to basically generate its output for this. And it wrote the email. And I think this is definitely a better quality product than if it was just something that was just pasting in a small prompt into Claude or into ChatGPT or into Gemini, any of these things. So the idea of this Metaprompt and the way that they've given the collab for doing this, I think is actually really cool. And it's definitely worth you experimenting with this and sort of seeing, okay, how could you apply this to the apps that you're building, to the agents that you are building? I think this is giving some really nice prompting for agents, where when I see a lot of the prompts that people write for agents, they're just very generic and they're not really specific enough to the tool or to the use that the person wants to actually get out of this. Anyway, have a play with it. Let me know what you think in the comments. As always, if you've got questions, put them in the comments below. If you found the video useful, please click like and subscribe, and I will talk to you in the next video. Bye for now.